Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our mains answer writing series. So friends, we have a series in which what we do, we daily give you a certain number of questions of which you have to write the answers. So certain students were demanding that sir, please start also an initiative in which you discuss the answers of the questions you share. So for example, we daily give you 5 questions. So they were saying, sir, please discuss these 5 questions in detail. So what we have decided, that we will be discussing daily 1 question, because discussing all the 5 questions will be kind of a hard task, because video will be stretched for too long. So for that purpose, only 1 question will be analyzed by us, and your today's question is about borrowing. That is the sovereign bonds that the recently announced budget proposed that a part of government borrowing will be raised in external currency, we can say foreign currency, by issuing bonds in for global financial markets. So here the question is, Union government has recently proposed to raise a part of its borrowings by issuing sovereign bonds in foreign financial markets. Critically analyze the step. So you might be knowing about this news, friends, that I will not delve too much into this detail. So we have to basically just critically analyze that whether this action will be good for India or will be bad for India. So you will have to look at both the aspects. So when there is a directive that is critically analyzed, then you must keep in mind that you have to focus upon both the positive aspects and the negative aspects, and then in conclusion you have to give a balance just. So you can start by simply giving a simple statistics. For example, here we have started that before starting, let me tell you friends that this is not a model answer, because no answer in UPSC can be model answer. Had that been the case, all the students would have scored 100% marks, but the toppers score only 50 to 55% of the marks. So don't consider this answer as a model answer. So we have just started it by giving introduction that Nirmala Sitharaman, that is the finance minister of India, currently under NDA 2, she became the first finance minister to agree to borrow in foreign currency to finance the fiscal deficit in the full budget of 2019-20. So the proposed plan is to raise up to 10 to 15% of government borrowing. That ranges amounts to close to approximately $10 billion. So from the first overseas sovereign bond. So in total, the central government wants to raise an amount of rupees 7.1 lakh crore. But this is total amount of out of this total amount, 10 to 15% will be raised externally. So it means that we will be start borrowing from external markets in external currency. So please note this word, we will be borrowing in external markets in external currencies. So we will not be borrowing in rupee, but we will be borrowing in foreign currency. So this is a marked change from the past, when India issued the government bonds only in rupees. So let me clarify here you that this is not the first time that India is borrowing externally. India has borrowed externally earlier as well, but the issuance of bonds was in kind of, we can say, rupees and not in dollars. But now we will be issuing our sovereign bonds in foreign currency. So we have borrowed, and in fact we have borrowed only from official lenders like World Bank. So we haven't entered any private market so far, that matter. So there are two possible rationales that could be cited here that were in fact referred to by the finance minister also when she presented the budget. So in the speech she said that India's sovereign external debt is lowest among is lowest globally among the lowest globally. That is at present it is less than 5%, close to 3.8% is to GDP is the sovereign external debt. So, and second is also that this will have a beneficial impact on the demand situation for the government securities in domestic market. So what does it mean that these government securities will have demand in India in domestic market? Because when the government securities when government is issuing security in foreign markets, then there is a prospect of proper demand in kind of domestic market also. So the positives here are, as I have told you, that we have to look at both the positive and the negative aspect. So here you can see that introduction, but you don't have to write that much of introduction. We are providing you introduction in a comprehensive manner so that you can reduce it to 20 to 25 words. So you can simply refer to by that this budget proposed to raise 10 to 15% of the government borrowings from external sources under in external currency. And then you can simply shift to the positives and negatives of this step. So the positive is that first of all the very important fact is that currently the public sector borrowing by government puts significant pressure on market rates in India along with the liquidity in system. So what does it mean? So basically, as you let's assume a scenario. For example, government borrows from a particular bank, and then this borrowing by the government puts significant pressure on the market rates, because if government borrows excessively and if the money supply is obviously if limited in the country, then a very small amount of money will be there that will be available for the private sector to which they can lay claim, that is to which against which they can kind of claim loans. So in fact this public government borrowing creates a significant pressure on market rates, that is market rates are pushed high because the liquidity reduces, and this also affects monetary policy. For example, if the RBI has monetary is favoring the, we can say, cheap monetary policy, but the excessive government borrowing will not result in that much of transformation at the ground level of cheap monetary policy. So this will affect monetary policy also, as well as liquidity, as well as will put pressure on market rates, so that the loans will be available to private sector at higher interests. So they will not borrow, and then all that vicious circle, that is no borrowing, then no investment, all these things will be there. So there is so currently there are large level of local borrowings, and these could drive up interest rates, as I've told you, and it could crowd out the private sector. So the next save option is borrowing abroad. So one thing that one possible reason for introducing this step is that government can borrow from abroad, and the domestic resources are available to the private sector. So also one more benefit of it is that, for example, if in the domestic market the interest rates are high, and if in the market abroad in the global market the interest rates are not much high, then government can borrow from external sources at cheap interest rates. So that will be a kind of advantage of low global interest rates to the government. And also, as I have told you earlier, the one reason is that India's sovereign debt is not that much as of now. So it is below 5%. Let me tell you, friends, that I am referring here to sovereign debt. I am not referring to external debt. So sovereign, and there is a difference between sovereign debt and government and complete debt a country that a country has. So currently it is below 5% and it is lowest in the world. So this makes the move relatively risk free. And also the basic idea is that shifting abroad, it will reduce the pressure on the domestic market and will keep the interest rates at lower level so that the private sector can borrow. So then also there is deficit financing through resources garnered in domestic market can put considerable strain on loanable funds available to private investors, as I have told you. So this is again a point that that leads to crowding out effect, that is no availability of funds so that the private sector can borrow loans. And then also in particular this point gains importance particularly in the context that savings have consistently declined in India. So for example, in 2011-12, the savings were 34.6% of the GDP. But now the savings have reduced to 30.5% to the GDP in 2017-18. So this shows that the capital market is not that much vibrant. That is, financial markets are not that much vibrant. So the funds are not available. Liquidity is not there. So when already there is liquidity crunch due to lack of savings, due to declining savings, then obviously the borrowing by the government further from the domestic market will further reduce the funds that will be available to private sector. So this in way help in easing the upward pressure on domestic interest rate and will free up domestic loanable funds. So also then there is a the cost of borrowing is expected to be cheaper because dollar or yen interest rates are lower than rupee interest rates. So normally this is the case that the rupee interest rate is normally high, and the interest rates over in when you borrow in dollar or yen, it is less. That's why this could open a source, or we can say open a channel from which government can get loanable funds at cheaper rate. So then there are also negative aspects of this step. Negatives are first of all there is currency risk. So obviously, for example, if you are borrowing from external market in external currency, suppose you are borrowing in dollar, then there will be more inflow of foreign currency into the country, which will automatically appreciate, will lead to the appreciation of rupee. So if enough appreciation takes place, it will affect your export sector. And for example, then there could be also a scenario where for example when the rupee is depreciated. So for example, if today government borrowed $100 and it promised to return $120 on maturity, then you might be seeing that only 20% interest is there. But consider here a scenario of depreciation in rupee, because ultimately when government has to pay $120, then it has to convert its rupee into dollar, and then only it will be able to repay the creditor which has provided the credit to the government. So for example, if there is at that time when the loan is to be returned, there is depreciation in rupee, then the government will have to arrange for more rupee so that appropriate amount of rupees are available to convert into $120. So that will increase the liability, obviously government liability. So in you can see that nominal interest rate will be 20%, but if for example there is much depreciation of rupee, then the amount of rupee that have to be converted into dollar, that they will be quite large, and this will result in high net interest. So if there is overall increase in import of foreign capital, and it could put upward pressure on the rupee, because if enough appreciation takes place, then export sector will be harmed. And then there is volatility issue. So for example, if government is borrowing today and interest rate is low, then that is good. But for example, when there is a maturity of the loan, when the government has to repay the loan, for example, at that time the global markets have very high interest rates, then also government will be exposed to the vagaries of global financial market, because at that time the government will have to repay the loan at the prevalent interest rate in the global market. So this trend will have a significant impact on the government's exposure. So in India might have to repay more than it had originally taken as loan. And then there is also investment issue. So investment, how this will affect investment in rupee denominated government bonds. For example, if today the government of India is issuing bonds only in rupee, then the rupee will be will be demanded in the global market. So but if government is now issuing bonds that are in foreign currency, so obviously a person if he is from USA, for example, then obviously he will buy the bonds that are in foreign currency, because on that, for example, if there is $100, the interest is of $20, and he will be getting $120 on maturity, then he will not have any concern about what happens to rupee, that is whether it appreciates or whether whether it depreciates. He will be getting $120 and he will not be concerned about the appreciation or depreciation of rupee. So this will kind of discourage the investment in rupee, and this will obviously kind of decrease the demand of rupee. So if we are saying that foreign currency is coming, then foreign currency rupee will be appreciated. It is a beneficial thing. Then there is also negative point, negative aspect to this thing, that is if the rupee is not demanded in foreign market, in global market, then there will be depreciation of rupee. So this is because they will have the option of investing in hard currency bonds and avoid the currency risk associated with the rupee. So this will lead to higher volatility in the currency. So both in debt as well as currency markets. Also then sources is the issue. The use of sovereign bonds indicates that the government may be running out of sources to borrow with from within India. So this may kind of give a message that government doesn't have enough sources that through which it could borrow domestically. Then it has to move. It has to turn to global market. So this is not a good message, and also it must be notable that though the sovereign debt is less than 5%, but if we see debt to GDP ratio, then our debt to GDP ratio is 68.4. So it is combined, from Indian sources as well as from external sources. So India's debt to GDP ratio is among the worst among the emerging markets, and next only to Brazil. So India's total debt has risen by almost 50% since 2014. So that is a big issue. And then there is also risk of dollarization of sovereign debt rather than being denominated in the local currency. So if there is dollarization of sovereign debt, then you will have to pay in dollars while on the maturity of the loan, and then this will lead to demand of the dollar. For example, if today the dollar is coming into the country, but when you have to repay the loan, then you will have to repay in dollars. Then there will be demand from the Indian government of dollar. Then there will be kind of dollarization of sovereign debt, and this can adversely affect countries' foreign exchange reserves, because now the loan will not be denominated in local currency. And then also there could be currency risk could be significant, and as a result, foreign currency denominated sovereign can easily become a self-perpetuating cycle. So for example, if there is a depreciated rupee and government has to repay the loan, and much of kind of rupee has to be arranged, and then so that the government can repay the loan, and then this will ensure that at the time of redemption the cost becomes higher. So it will adversely impact to your fiscal deficit also if there is a depreciation in rupee. So this may induce government to further borrow to meet the fiscal deficit target, or to ensure that the funds with the government remain adequate. So this will again lead to further issuance of sovereign bonds in foreign currency, because that will bring then foreign currency, and that will bring there will be availability of rupee, because RBI will have to print the currency, and the rupee will be available with the government. So this issue then can easily break the ceiling of such issuances which has been kind of targeted at 10 to 15% in the budget speech. So this can come under strain, and then there is also foreign currency raised will need to be converted into rupees by Reserve Bank of India. So for example, if government has borrowed in foreign currency, then obviously in India it will be requiring rupee to transact its business. Then it will turn to RBI, and RBI will print more currency, more currency in rupee to buy government's currency that is with government, that is in foreign currency. So RBI will have to print more money, and that money will then obviously will come into supply chain. So there will be rupee supply, and there will be depreciation. So this will induce fresh money into the system, and this may lead further to the problem of depreciation of rupee. And then there might also be the issue of we can say due to this depreciation there will be kind of threat to other macro indicators. So this is precisely what the government has done whenever there is an increase in net RBI credit to government of India. So for example, fiscal deficit is why fiscal deficit is high, because sometimes government now we are targeting in this budget, the finance minister has revised the target of fiscal deficit to 3.3%. So earlier also there was much fiscal deficit, and what was the government doing? Government was borrowing heavily from RBI to meet its populist measures. So due to this there was much currency that used to be in circulation, and that impacted monetary policy and also rupee value and also other macro indicators. So this will precisely happen if when government brings funds in foreign currency. So rupees get created and they will be infused into the system and money supply will increase, and this will impact the monetary policy and all other things. So foreign currency denominated sovereign bonds, however, will once again ensure that RBI will have to print rupees to the extent of government of India's borrowings in foreign currency. So RBI printed money to finance. This is basically the problem which the government of India was earlier facing. So this will ensure that RBI prints money to finance successive government's populism. So that is not a good economics. And then also, instead of getting determined chiefly by the level of economic activity, the quantum of money will be dependent and will be dictated by government's need for its budget. For example, if there is the government is requiring high funds for its budget, then it will simply change the route. It will not just directly turn to the RBI, but it will indirectly turn to the RBI by borrowing externally and then turning to RBI. So there will be no difference. There will be a kind of no difference between the earlier policy, fiscal policy, which was followed and which deteriorated macroeconomic indicators of government of India, and there is a doubt that this may persist later also. And then we must also do the analysis to get this plan work out. So according to 2015 study by International Monetary Fund on international sovereign bonds by developing economies, it concluded that the countries that have strong fiscal and external positions and strong government effectiveness mattered for successful bond issuance, market access, and for lower bond spreads. So as of now, as I've told you, that India's sovereign debt to GDP sovereign external debt to GDP ratio is 3.8% and 19.1% of total external debt in March 2019. So global investors are also finding the government of India's growth story credible. So there is kind of a headstrong to augment such overseas borrowings now. So we can as of now can borrow, but we have to carefully look at the issues also that may lead to further problem. So with the current account deficit also in control, and then there is external then exchange reserves also at a historic high of $427.7 billion. So there is an economic bandwidth that is available to get into the global sovereign bond market now. And also India's sovereign ratings have improved. The Moody, that is a sovereign we can say assign ratings to the sovereign governments. So it has upgraded India's investment grade to BAA2. So it is the first such upgrade since 2004. So this is a kind of, we can say, choice available. There is a kind of choice available before government, and this shall significantly impact the demand and rates for the sovereign Indian paper. So lastly, we have to also look into the aspect that whether other options are also available. So some people are saying that why to borrow in foreign currency? If we want more foreign currency, what we can do is we can raise the limit limit over products in portfolio investments. So for example, if there is a current ceiling on a foreign portfolio investment into government rupee bonds, then we can lift that ceiling and we can increase that ceiling. So this will ultimately will the effect will be same, that is the more foreign inflows, but the government security will be issued in rupees. And other thing is, far better than issuing a foreign currency bond abroad is that we could relax our requirements for foreigners to register as foreign portfolio investors so that they can invest in India and more foreign currency can flow into India. So also other thing which is very important is India has shown the intent that it wants to internationalize rupee as a currency. So when the government of India is looking for internationalization of rupee, then eventually, if for example we are issuing bonds in foreign currency, then obviously we are creating a competition for our own currency. But because we have the intention to internationalize the rupee, so if we will not sell the bonds in rupee and we will not encourage the liquidity or assets in rupee, then who will do so? So we have to increase the assets and the liquidity in rupee so that the rupee can get internationalized. So first step has been taken to make rupee more attractive. So currently inflation is down, so domestic inflation is down, so rupee has become more attractive. So next is to step what could have been done, rupee assets could be made more desirable and liquid. But if any case, for example, if internationalization is not the ultimate goal but it is just an intent, and then the case is also there, then that why to create unnecessary competition for rupee assets by issuing by issuing bonds in foreign currency, and also the Indian markets by denominating India's most sought after financial asset, its government bond, in foreign currency. And lastly, in conclusion, we can say that as currently the ceiling is 10 to 15% of total borrowings, and also as macroeconomic fundamentals are strong and now the foreign exchange reserve position is also strong, and all the things, for example, inflation is down and all these things, the government's external debt is sovereign external debt is less, and then there is a space though available for the government to kind of borrow from abroad, but this plan to kind of arrange revenues must, in foreign currency, must ensure that the expenditure that the government takes is in a very, very, we can say, prudent manner, so that there is no fiscal profligacy. And also then government can constitute for example fiscal council, independent fiscal council, as was recommended by N.K. Singh committee. So, and it recommended that there must be a council which must evaluate the fiscal policy of the government. So one more additional task could be given to this independent fiscal council, that is the task of suggesting government on the sustainable level of foreign borrowing. So that if that particular institutional mechanism is in place and it guides government on sustainable levels of foreign borrowing, then government will there will be a kind of expert advice available to the government, and also there will be a kind of increase in confidence of the investor, because if there is a kind of confidence in the investor confidence that the investor enjoys in your bonds, then gradually it will it helps in reducing the borrowing cost in the system. So this is all about today's question, and if you like this question, then do ensure that you like it. And lastly, friends, as you have seen that 27 minutes have been consumed, so it is difficult to discuss all the 5 questions. And lastly, if you are interested in joining our daily mains answer writing initiative, and then you can join using this link, and this link will also be provided in the description box. So benefits of joining it is that we provide 5 questions, out of which 3 are from your current topic and 2 are from your static topic. So what we do, we not only provide you questions, but we also evaluate comprehensively your answer and also provide you valuable feedback. And also we not just provide you feedback, we also provide you reference sources for all the questions. For example, you have seen the reference source for this particular question only, and when if in case you join, you will be given reference sources for all the questions. And also it is least costly because you can join on a monthly basis also. So the link will be provided in the description box. So if in case you are interested to join, then you can join it. And lastly, ensure that you subscribe to our channel. And this is all about today's video, friends. Thank you. Have a very nice day ahead.